Lost are saved, find their way at the sound of your great name. All condemned, feel no shame at the sound of your great name. Every fear has no place at the sound of your great name. The enemy, he has to leave at the sound of your great name. Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us. Son of God and man, you are high and lifted up, that all the world will praise your great name. All the weak find their strength at the sound of your great name. The fatherless, they find their rest at the sound of your great name. Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us. Son of God and man, you are high and lifted up, that all the world will praise. Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us. Son of God and man, you are high and lifted up, that all the world will praise your great name. Redeemer, my healer, Lord, Almighty, my Savior, Defender, you, Almighty, Redeemer, my healer, Lord, Almighty, my Savior, Defender, you, Almighty. Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us. Son of God and man, you are high and lifted up, that all the world will praise. Jesus, worthy is the Lamb that was slain for us. Son of God and man, you are high and lifted up, that all the world will praise your great name. Your great name. Your great name. God Almighty reigns. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. For the Lord God Almighty reigns. To love you with all. stand forever in your mighty hand, living with your promise written on my heart. I am yours, surrender wholly to you. Set me in your family, calling me your own. Now I belong to you. Call on me, your spirit, your word, your truth. Hear my cry, my deep desire to know you more. In your name I will lift my hands to the King. This anthem of praise I bring, heaven knows I long to love you with all I am. Now I belong to you. All I need, your spirit, your word, your truth. Hear my cry, my deep desire to know you more. In your name I will lift my hands to the King. This anthem of praise I bring, heaven knows my deep desire to know you more. In your name I will lift my hands to the King. This anthem of praise I bring, heaven knows I long to love you with all I am. I belong to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, we belong to you, Lord. Glory to Jesus. Somebody shout hallelujah in the house.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah in the house. Hallelujah. And if you are watching online, type in hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Welcome to the September 2023 edition of Special Miracle Service. The Lord is good. And all the time. This morning or tonight, depending on where you are right now, this moment, amen. We are going to pray. How many of you believe in the power of prayers? How many believe that God answers prayers? How many know that when you call, God will answer? You see, our God is like the good dad. We know that not everyone
every dad is a good dad. And you know what? Sometimes it's not because the dads want to be evil or the dad love to be, you know, to be a bad dad. No, but situations, many times we cause dads not to be good. Situations, environmental influences, you know, bloodline curses. Many times we cause dads not to be a good dad. But good dad, we know. If you go to a good dad, if a child go to a good dad and say, "Daddy, I want candy," and this good dad has the money to buy, and this good dad has candy at home, and this good dad knows that candy is good for the child, will the good dad not give the candy to the child? Will he not? Hello? If a good dad has candy and the child is coming and he said, "Daddy, I want candy," you are a good dad. Won't you give the candy to the child?
I will.
Because the child asks. Right? Okay, let me give another example. Your child needs $5. And you have $1 million. And your child is coming, "Daddy, can I have $5? Will you say, "No, I'm not going to give you. Get out." Is that what you're going to say?
No.
No. And I have good news for us. Our God is not just a good dad. Our God does not have situations around him that will cause him not to bless us. Our God has every resources it will take for him to bless us. Somebody say amen. That is our God. He's got everything it will take for him to bless us. When he knows it's not good for us, he will hold it. He will hold it because holding it will make us good. Amen. So that is the reason sometimes you ask about something from God and God is not releasing it to you. You know why God is doing that? Because probably that thing is going to harm you. It's just like you're 10 years old. You say, "Daddy, can I drive your car?" You love the child. You love your 10-year-old. You love your 10-year-old more than your car, correct? But you won't let him drive it. Why? Because it is not time for him to drive the car. So that is how it is sometimes. When we ask something from the Lord, sometimes the Lord might tell us, "Wait." You might not hear the big old voice or the tiny voice, whatever voice it is, saying, telling you, "Wait." But what you experience is that you are just still in that situation, it's not changing. And then when you go past the situation, you say, "Oh, thank God, God didn't even answer that prayers." I've had to ask God for some things in my life. And God did not answer. And years after, I'm there rolling in praises and thanks to God that he didn't answer that prayers. Because if he had answered our prayers, things would have gone wrong. You know, we don't know better. God knows best. We can't see beyond our nose. God sees even into the future. So I've said that to say that we are going to pray. And we are praying to the good dad. We are praying to the good Lord. We are praying to the God who answers prayers. And we are praying to the God who not only answers prayers, but has all the resources it takes for him to answer our prayers. Somebody say amen. So let's rise on our feet this morning. And we got to close our eyes because that's how we pray. We got to close our eyes so we can focus in our prayers. And we got to lift our voices up to the Lord. Please don't be quiet. This is the time to pray. This is the time to present yourself to the Lord. This is that time to present your needs to the Lord. This is that time to tell him the reason you are here. Many of us are here for different reasons. Many want deliverance. Many need deliverance. Many need healings. Many need financial breakthrough. Some need restoration in their homes, in their relationship. Some need restoration in their business. Some need to be promoted. Some need have different needs. Some of us are even standing here today for our family members, for our friends. So right now, if you are hearing the sound of my voice, I want you to rise on your feet and I want you to start praying and tell the Lord the reason you are here. Come on. Tell him the reason you are here. Tell him why you are here. Speak it to the Lord right now. Speak it to the Lord right now. Close your eyes and speak it to the Lord. Tell him the reason you are here. Tell him the reason you are here. Lord, I'm here so you might touch me. Lord, I'm here so you might touch me. Lord, I'm here so you might touch me. I'm hooked to this presence so you might touch me. I am hooked to this internet so you might touch me. I am hooked to this Facebook so you might touch me. I have come here today so you might touch me. Come on, tell him. Tell him, I've come so you might touch me. I've come so you will bless me. I've come so you will save me. I've come so you will deliver me. I've come so you will heal me. I've come for breakthrough. I have come for breakthrough. I've come so my prayers will be answered. Come on, pray. Pray, tell him. Lord, I have come. I've come so you will touch me. I've come so you will heal me. I've come so you will make me strong. I've come so you will deliver me. I've come so all those demons will go away. I've come to be healed. I've come so my medical reports will change. Oh, come and pray. Come and pray. Pray, pray, pray this moment. This is the time to cry unto the Lord. This is the time to cry unto the Lord. I've come so those blood work can change. Come on, pray. Lord, those blood work needs to change. Those medical reports need to change. The fever needs to go. The cancer needs to go. The diabetes needs to go. The hypertension needs to go. The poverty needs to go. The bone pain needs to go. Pray. The mental illness needs to leave. Come and pray because we have the God who answers prayers. We have the God who answers prayers. The restriction needs to stop. Randa de Boshandaria Maskenderia. In the name of Jesus, come and pray. I need to be healed. I need deliverance, Lord. I need deliverance, Lord. I need to be set free. Come on. Cry to the Lord right now. Cry to the Lord. As you hear me, cry to the Lord. Ire hebo shandariyama. Ire kabarandere bo shanda. We have come to meet you, Lord. Come and tell him, Lord, I have come to meet you. I've come to meet with you. I've come for a blessing. I've come for a lifting. I've come that my prayers be answered. Come and pray. Wherever you are, in Nigeria, in Pakistan, in Africa, in India, in Indonesia, in Liberia, in Syria, Lord, come and pray right now. Pray, say, tell the Lord, I have come. In Ghana, in Togo, I have come. In UK, come and pray. Randere boshanda. Randere bosemderi bashanda. I have come, Lord, that I might be touched. I have come, Lord, that I might be touched. I have come, Lord, that I might be touched. I am listening that I might be touched. Come on, push. Let's push, people. Pray until something happens to you. Pray until you feel something in your soul. Rekabarandere bashanda. Erenderi bababashandari amasene. In the name of Jesus. Everybody say amen. We are going to pray from Psalm 92. Psalm 92 and verse 9 says, for surely your enemies, Lord, surely your enemies will perish. All evildoers will be scattered. Surely your enemies will perish, O Lord, surely. Do you know your enemies are the enemies of the Lord?
Yes, yes.
Those who walk against you, they are walking against the Lord. Those who rebel against you are rebelling against the Lord. Those who gossip you and backbite you, they are gossiping and backbiting against the Lord. So you're going to pray right now. Lord, every enemy that is fighting against my life, let them perish right now in the name of Jesus. Come on, pray. It's in the word of God. Let them perish. Let them perish. Barinda rababashanda. For surely, Lord, surely your enemies shall perish. All evildoers shall scatter. Lord, let your enemies perish. Every spirit of darkness, every evil spirit, every mammon spirit, every witchcraft spirit, every voodoo spirit, every marine spirit working against your life, I command them to perish right now. In the name of Jesus, shout amen.
Amen.
Come and pray it. Every enemy of my soul, everyone that will not let me move forward, every power that won't let me move forward, every power that won't let me have my freedom, every power that won't let me have that promotion at work, every power sitting against my promotion, sitting on my promotion that won't let me move forward, all the devils, all the demons that are jealous, that are backbiting, that are carrying rumors against me,
In the name of Jesus, let them scatter. In the name of Jesus, let them fall before my face. In the name of Jesus, let them scatter. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Somebody say amen. Give the Lord some praise in the house. Hallelujah. Then you are going to pray, Lord, exalt me. Ha. How many of you need some exaltation? Oh, you okay with where you are right now? Are you okay with the level you are right now? Don't you want to go higher? Woo! Don't you want to go higher? I tell the Lord, Lord, every year of my life should be higher than the previous. Amen. Every year of my life should be higher than the previous years. In every area. Your relationship better. Your family better. Your children are promoting. Amen. Everything's going smoothly with you. If you were struggling with mortgage before, no more. Struggling to pay your rent, no more. Struggling to change your car, no more. So you pray right now, Lord, exalt me. I need more exaltation. I need more promotion. I need to promote. Come on, I need to promote. Come on, pray right now. Pray right now. Lord, I need to promote. 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 Exalt me, exalt me, exalt me. Exalt me, exalt me, exalt me. Exalt me, lift me higher. I need some lifting. I want to go out of this place today. I want to go out of this program today. Exalted, exalted, promoted, lifted high in the name of Jesus. High above principalities, high above powers, high above demons, high above powers of darkness, high above the rulers of the wicked people in this world. High, 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 exalt me, Lord. Exalt me, Lord. In my relationship, better. In my relationship with my spouse, better. My relationship with my children, better. My relationship with my household, better. In everything, my relationship with my co-workers, better. My relationship with my co-student, better. My relationship with my business partners, better. Lord, exalt me. Lord, exalt me. Lord, exalt me. Lord, exalt us. Come on, pray, 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 pray. Lord, exalt us. Oh, render boshanda. Rehemoshende. Ah, higher, higher, higher. I'm going higher. In the name of Jesus, I'm going higher. I'm moving higher. I'm going higher. Higher in my education. Higher at my job. Higher in relationship. Higher in finances. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Things might be hard, but I will go higher. Things might be difficult, but I'm climbing higher. People might not find food to eat, but I will have abundance. I will have abundance and even to give out. In the name of Jesus. People might lack, but I will not lack. Come on, pray. People might lack, but I will not lack. People might lack, but I will not lack. I will lack. I will not lack any good thing. Come on, pray, decree. I will not lack any good thing. I will have much abundance. Abundance enough to give out. Enough to share. Enough to give away. Enough to share in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. People, these are the kind of prayers you should be praying. Keep coming here and we'll teach you to pray. And your life will never remain the same again. Somebody say amen. I love to be blessed enough to give out. That's why sometimes you see me on Facebook giving money out to people, giving money, sharing money to the needy. You know, because it is what prayer I prayed in my life when I was struggling, when we had no food to eat, when we had to borrow money to buy food to eat. I prayed all these kind of prayers. We prayed it, we groaned. Fall on our faces and we groan in prayers. Lord, bless us so we have enough to give out to people. Today, I'm going to be on YouTube, on my channel, giving out money to people. I made the announcement a few days ago. People are going to hook up because people out there need money. If you think you are blessed enough, you don't need more. Please pray for more so we can give it to others, right? Because people out there need money. They need it. People need it. Oh my God. They will pray for you. They will groan for you. Every day they wake up, they will pray for you. 3 days ago, I received a text message, a voice message from somebody that benefited from the money I gave out. Some of these people, I don't know them. I just put it out there. And I do something for them to win it. So it will be random. And this person sent me a voice note, was singing, using my name to sing. And praying for me, composes. Oh my God, I listen to it. I'm like, Jesus, how the giving touched her. Listen, I'm saying this to challenge every one of us. Because we have heard in the past, one day, the man of God here, you know, taught us about prosperity. How God can change our lives and bless us with more. And some of the church members said, no, we don't need the money. Why do we need the money? I'm okay the way I am. So I went to this guy, said, if you're okay the way you are, that's fine. But please, if you have any extra on top of your okay, can you pass it to me? So I can give it to those who need it. Amen. So when we pray like this, don't let it end like this. When you go back home, continue the prayers. Amen. Sometimes you can write down these prayers and then you continue to pray them at home. Today, get ready for a touch. Today, I say today, this very day, get ready for a touch. Because God is coming to touch you big time. Big time, divine embrace. Some of us will look at the theme of this month, divine embrace. What does that mean? All right, get ready now to see and to hear what it means. As welcome God's servants. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Praise God forevermore. My name is Israel Jima. I want to welcome all of you to this special monthly event today. Right now, as we are here in this auditorium to partake of this special time with the Holy Spirit, there are about 500,000 people listening in with their radio. So if you are listening to me right now in Ghana, get ready for the power of God today. You are listening in Liberia through Worship FM, get ready for the power of God today. If you are listening in Sierra Leone, in Restoration FM, get set for God's power today. Those of you who are watching on the big screen in Nigeria and in Liberia, get ready for God's blessing today. Amen. You are watching us live on Bright Star Christian TV right now in Pakistan. Get ready. Jesus from heaven will do a wonder in your life today.
Amen.
Now, gather people around you to be a part of this service. In these meetings like this, God always performs wonders. Right here in this place some months ago, this is very brother Jason. Remember, I was ministering and God told me somebody has been healed inside their mouth. I said it here. And he said he was one. He said immediately something came out of his mouth. One person was here in another service like that, like this. She fell by the power of God. The power of God fell on her. She was on the floor. When she fell down, her short leg grew out right here. By Jesus. By Jesus. Now you will hear some testimonies. Sister Marcella will come read to us some testimonies of those who have been saved, healed, delivered, and set free. I want you to just key in and get set for your blessing today.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Blessings, everyone. Jesus transforms the life of Aliu of Sierra Leone. Hello, Pastor Israel Jema. My name is Aliu Kane. I am a constant listener to your service on Restoration FM from Sierra Leone. When I was in college, I fell away from God and joined some friends that were living anyhow. I was in public school, and all my friends hated the Word of God because what we were doing was not good in the eyes of God. 2 months before my graduation, something miraculous happened that changed my life forever. I met this lady who is a true woman of God, and she introduced Healing Moments broadcast to me. She always checked on me every weekend and made sure we monitor the program together. Slowly, I started avoiding my friends and spending more time with God. Few weeks after constant listening and studying the Bible, I was convinced that Jesus Christ wanted me to change and come to Him. Pastor, through your prayers and preaching, God has intervened on my behalf and saved me from major deceptions. I am grateful, forever grateful, and thankful to the Almighty for this new beginning in my life. The words of God has humbled me so much. He is my strength. If anything good comes from me, it's the Almighty God. I have lost many friends for following Jesus, but the rewards are double. As Paul said, for me to live is Christ, and to die is gain. Aliu Kane. This was from July 29, 2023, from Sierra Leone. Our next testimony, Jesus delivers Arma of Ghana from fear and anxiety. Greetings, Pastor Israel. I came to know Christ as my friend and personal Savior in January 2021 through this broadcast. In my lowest times and sorrows, He is always with me at my side. God has sent me people like you to pray with me and stand with me through storms in my life. I developed anxiety and fear at a young age, and because of that, I found it difficult to make decisions or take a step forward. But since I got in contact with your radio broadcast through praying and reading the Bible, the fear began to go away. This broadcast always reminded me that Jesus Christ can take away any fear if we believe in Him. After months and months of listening to your preaching and following the way of God, I no longer experience fear or anxiety. It is a mystery. I want to use this means to praise and thank God for my healing. Arma Tool, from August 15, 2023. Jesus heals Oliver of Ghana instantly. Dear man of God, I have been listening to your preaching on Testimony FM for some time now, and I have received so many miracles that I cannot count. and I give glory to God. Last week, Sunday was not easy on me. I came down with fever that got my body hot and tired, taking some pills, but it did not work. When it was time for your preaching, I sat near the radio and trusted God to use you and heal me. Apostle Jima, as you were praying, I felt my body sweating, and right after the program, I was instantly healed, and the fever was gone just as it came. Pastor, I just want to appreciate the Lord for every blessing and healing in my life. Oliver Adanua, from Winnipeg, Ghana. This was in September 3, 2023. And our very last testimony. Amara is so blessed. She prays for Apostle Jima, August 15, 2023. Apostle Jima, thank you for having such an amazing ministry, full of knowledge, wisdom, and the power of Jesus Christ. You definitely have the gift of deliverance, and you are strong in spiritual warfare. You are always praying for us and intervene on our behalf to God. So I want to use this time to pray for you, Apostle. May the Lord Almighty continue to bless your hands, protect your family, and guide you as you teach his people the gospel. May you never lack anything in life, both physical and spiritual. The power, grace, and wisdom will always be with you. I pray that your ministry grows because you are being used by God to set his people free. God bless you, Apostle Jima. Amara Smith from Kasoa, Ghana. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Somebody say amen for me.
You want this one instead?
Okay. Thank you. Yeah, that's a prayer for me. So say amen to that. Amen to that. You know, I need prayers too. But thank God for what he's doing. Hallelujah. Thank you, wonderful Jesus. Praise God forevermore. Welcome to Divine Embrace. Welcome to the presence of the Holy Spirit. And for that which God is set to do in your life today, this very moment. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. How great God is. You had those testimonies? Give God praise for those testimonies. Give God praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Those are just samples of testimonies. We have our folder filled with testimonies from across the world. By the grace of God, we've been in this for a while, and we keep getting these testimonies every single week of lives being changed by the power of God, both here and from around the world. And today, I trust God to do a wonder in your own life. Just close your eyes and bow your head wherever you are. Say, Holy Spirit, work in my life today. Tell him, oh God, work your work in my life now. Work your work in my life, oh God, now. Thank you, wonderful Father. How great thou art, wonderful Jesus. Blessed be your name. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, unto thee, most holy one, how great thou art, how great thou art, my Lord. It's by your mercy and grace that we come before your throne, great God. It's by your mercy, your love, we proclaim your majesty. Hallelujah to your name. By your great kindness, my Lord, my King, we declare your great miracles. You are the only wise God, O Lord, There's no one else like you. That's why we sing and sing. My Savior God, unto thee, most holy one, how great thou art. Almighty one, how great thou art. You do miracles, then sings my soul. My Savior God, unto thee, no one like you, Lord, how great thou art. How great thou art. You reign in all the earth, my Lord. It's by your power that we stand against darkness. By your power, it's by your Spirit, the Holy Ghost, we declare your mighty words. It's by your glorious right hand, your hand of power, we walk in victory over hell. We lift you high, O Lord. You are above all else. No one comes close, then sings my soul, my Savior, my Lord, unto thee. Faithful one, how great thou art. Miracle working God, how great thou art. Glory to your name.
Then sings
my soul,
my Savior God,
unto thee. My delight changer, how great thou art. How great thou art. Hallelujah to your mighty name. As we bow before you today, walk, Lord, in our midst, O Lord. Touch everyone today, O Lord, with your mighty hand of love. Let your glory, let it flow upon everyone today, Lord, merciful one. We return the glory and the praise to you alone, unchanging one, then sings my soul, my Savior God, unto thee, Holy One, how great thou art. Laga sobro nende biga no so bigunaj. Eloke se veli kaguje. Then sings my soul, my Lord, my Savior, Lord, unto you. Higher than all, how great thou art. How great thou art. Eleso ma gabres ombra stongo debi zezes songlas ikino mancono sevenas ilacatombles efremenos ontolaga singnes limpras mongo fengles songono
Lekremish Efreman Destomenge Singines Inestokwama Vefremigados Ekolwa Sasia Gaga Emekweno Felivoivo Elekromingi Sefe Eta Fiaka Masa Pakados. Thank you, Lord, for your mighty power. Release right now into that room in the name of Jesus. And raising that woman from that bed of affliction right now. Thank you, Lord, for the angel of God just walked into that room right now. And you woman, you have been on that bed for 3 months, unable to move. Now you can rise and begin to walk. Jesus makes you whole now by his mighty power. Oh, blessed be your name, King of all the earth. Thank you, Lord, for the moving of your spirit today. Unto Jesus be the glory now and forever. And everyone right here and those that watch, say amen. Say a believing amen. Say a believing amen. I feel the glory. I feel the glory of God. I know when it's there. I feel it. I feel the glory of God. This is the glory that opens blind eyes. I feel it. The power of God that sets the captives free. I feel it right now. Divine embrace. We know what the word embrace means. To embrace is to hold someone closely in one's arms, especially as a sign of affection. To embrace, to hold somebody to your arms, to yourself, it's a sign of affection. It also means to accept or support willingly and enthusiastically a belief, a theory, or a change. It means to accept or support a change, a theory, a belief willingly and enthusiastically. It also means to support somebody willingly and do it with all your enthusiasm. So that's the two various meanings of the word embrace. I'm focusing today on embrace that is holding someone close to your arms. There are benefits in natural physical embrace. All human beings benefit from embrace. Now, plenty of research have shown that hugging, which is embrace, lowers blood pressure, lowers heart rate, and stress hormones, including cortisol. In fact, one study found that getting a 20-second hug just before a public speaking lowers heart rate, as well as systolic and diastolic blood pressure. Even physical warm embrace does that to us as human beings. So there are benefits to physical hugging, embrace of human beings. Now, how about hugging and embracing God? How about when God, the divine, gives us an embrace? When human beings give you an embrace, you get those benefits. How about when you are involved in divine embrace? When the person embracing you is not just human, but God himself. What happens to you? What are the consequential blessings of divine embrace? Now, in Luke 15, Jesus told us a parable of the prodigal son. A parable that many of us know very well. This man had two sons. The younger son said, "Father, I'm tired of living under your roof. Let me go my separate ways. Give me my portion of your inheritance when you die. Give me now. You are still alive, but give me now. That means you better die and let me go." However, the father lovingly gave him his share of the inheritance. He went away and blew everything away. In that parable, the father represents God, and the prodigal son represents you and me who stray away from God. The senior son who was in the house represents those of us who are with God, who have not strayed away from God. But in the parable, the father represents God. So let me read to you Luke chapter 15 from verse 11. Luke 15 verse 11. And he said, "A certain man had two sons. And the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of the goods that falleth to me. He divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country. He went far from home. Many times, rebels don't stay close. They go far from where they will have help. He went to a far country. And there, wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land. And he began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country. And he sent him into his field to feed swine, pigs. And he would fain have filled his belly with the husk that the swine did eat, and no man gave unto him. When he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger? I will arise and go to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee, and I am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of thy servants, thy hired servants. And he arose and came to his father. 20. But when he was a great way afar off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. The prodigal son, after he had lived a wasted life, spent all he had, and he was now in tremendous penury. Life to him was just meaningless. He came back to his senses. I'll go back to my father. When he became and approached home, the father saw him. The young man was walking towards home. When the father saw him, the father ran toward him. One was walking, the other was running. The young man was just walking towards home. The dad saw him and the dad ran toward him. King James said here, and he fell on his neck and kissed him. That's King James language. That actually means he embraced him. In the Amplified Bible, that verse 20 goes like this. Luke 20 says, so he got up and came to his own father. But while he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was moved with pity and tenderness for him. And he ran and embraced him. That's the word. And embraced him and kissed him fervently. His father in this parable, like we said, represents God. The father of this prodigal son, when he saw the son coming towards him, he ran to him, and the Amplified says, he embraced him and kissed him fervently. Remember we said earlier, in the meaning of the word embrace, to hold to one's arms closely out of affection. But in this case, we are told that this prodigal son's father, in our case, Almighty God, Jesus, embraced him and kissed him fervently. So this is where divine embrace comes from. This divine embrace is what we are here for today in this special monthly program. Those of us who are here in this place and those who are watching all over the world, So the father of this young man ran to him and embraced him. And that's what Jesus is doing for us in this service today. Now, how do we provoke this divine embrace? In the case of that young man, he decided to go back to his father. He had been away from his father. So the father ran to him and embraced him. But we provoke divine embrace, hear this, whenever we turn our undivided attention to God and draw near to him. I say again, we provoke divine embrace whenever we turn our undivided attention to God and we draw near unto him. In the case of this story, This young man, he came towards his father. His father ran to him. The young man, he turned his undivided attention to his father, to whom? He removed his attention from his bad friends he had. For sure, he has some bad friends because he went and lived a riotous life. He lived a life of sin. So he must have had some friends in that level who they drank together, who they turned upon his father undividedly. He focused attention on his father and went to his father. For you and me as well, we provoke divine embrace when we turn our undivided attention to Jesus and we draw near to him. You are here today because you have come to draw near to him. Those of you who are connected, you are watching us on the big screen or listening on radio because you have come to draw near unto him. James chapter 4 verse 8 says, draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Just like that young man, draw near to God, and he will draw near to you. Cleanse your hands, you sinners. Purify your hearts, you double-minded. So, to have divine embrace, you must have single-mindedness, which is Jesus. 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 He must be the only thing on your mind. You must have single-minded focus. You must remove all distractions around you with an undivided attention, focus on the Lord, and draw near to him. When you do that, James 4, it says, he will come running to you, like we just read that story. That's when divine embrace is provoked. That's when we experience divine embrace. James 4, 8, the common English Bible says, come near to God, and it will come near to you. So you and I, we are the ones who take the initiative. We make the first move. We make the first move. When you make that first move, then God comes to you. If only God's son made the first move, I will go back to my father, he said. This father came running to him. You and I make the first move to draw nigh to God. And God says he will draw nigh to us. He said, wash your hands, you sinners, purify your hearts. You double-minded. When our heart is single-mindedly focused on Jesus, and we put action to our decision, not just by just thinking, we put action to it. This man said, I'll go to my father. He actually went. He put action to his decision. Many folks decide but no action. That is still indecision. If you make a decision, no action, you are yet to decide. The decision must give birth to practical action. So, if my attention is focused on Jesus, I will go to him. I will move towards him. Everyone here in this event today, right here, or those who are watching us anywhere you are in the world, or listening in, I believe that you have decided to focus on Jesus. And you are drawn nigh to him. So, today, he will draw nigh unto you and give you divine embrace. He will give you divine embrace. Somebody say amen to that. Jesus will give somebody divine embrace today. Ah, my God, I feel it. Nako Sapra. Jesus will give somebody divine embrace today. In this house and anyone who is watching around the world, he will give you divine embrace. What do you require? Undivided attention, focus on Jesus. And you draw to him. You draw near to him. Draw near to him. And we see that when that son went to the father and the father embraced him, great things happened. When the father embraced him, that activated some blessings for the young man. So when we experience divine embrace, blessings are activated for us. Blessings are triggered by divine embrace. Let me show you from Luke 15, the same story, from verse 21. It says, and the son said to his father, Father, I have sinned against heaven and in thy sight. I'm no more worthy to be called thy son. But the father said unto his servants, watch this now. Bring forth the best robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his hand and shoes on his feet. And bring hither the fatted calf and kill it. Let us eat and be merry. So when this young man was embraced by his father, he triggered 5 blessings. Divine embrace will trigger 5 blessings. So as you are here in this encounter today, through your divine experience of an encounter with God today, 5 blessings are being triggered for you now. 5 blessings are being triggered for you now. Makosa Debedesia. This young man experienced that embrace, and 5 blessings were triggered. So when you experience divine embrace today, 5 types of blessings will be triggered for you in the name of Jesus Christ. So get ready today for this divine embrace that triggers these 5 levels of blessings for you. Say amen, somebody. Say, I expect the triggered blessings, the activated blessings. Glory to God. Now, this is provoked by divine embrace. It was when that boy embraced his father, that's when those blessings were triggered for him. What are the blessings? Number one, the father said to his servants, watch this now, go get the best robe. Go get the ring for him. Go get shoes for his feet. And go arrange the house for party on his behalf. So first blessing that divine embrace triggers is angelic activation. God, the angels are the servants of God. So those who experience divine activation, God unleashed angels to work for them. Because God said to the father, said to the servants, which is the angels, go get the robe, put it on him. Go get the ring, put the ring on his hand. Put the shoes on his feet. And let the party get rolling on his behalf. All those were being triggered by the servants, which are the angels of God. So first blessing we get in divine embraces, angelic activities are triggered. And angels take over your case. Angels begin to work on your behalf. When you experience divine embrace, the ministry of angels is activated for you instantly. And the angels begin to fight your battles, crush your enemies, open doors for you by divine embrace. Divine embrace. So as you encounter divine embrace today, congratulations. Angels have taken over your battles. Angels are released on your behalf. That's what happens with divine embrace. Angelic activities are triggered by divine embrace. Not only that, he says, put on him the best robe. Say, best robe. Ooh, best robe. Wow, the best robe. Not just robe, but the best. Not just robe, the best robe. Oh, glory to God. Now, this all because of the divine embrace. Divine embrace puts upon you and me God's very robe of righteousness. Glory to God. God's robe of righteousness come. Now, let me do a little bit more on the first one. Angelic activation. In Hebrews 1:14, it says, the angels, are they not all ministering spirits sent forth to minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation? Yes, they are. So they are sent by God to minister for you who express divine embrace. Psalm 34, verse 7, the angel of the Lord encamps round about those who fear him and delivers them. And delivers them. Glory to God. In fact, the Amplified says, it says, and each of them, the angel of God delivers. So today, the angel will deliver you. Akebo Santa Beleso Ratila. As you in this divine embrace today, the angel of God will deliver you. You have been afflicted, you have been sick, you have been bound. Today, the angel of God will deliver you in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Somebody shout hallelujah. So in Acts chapter 12, verse 7 to 10, the angel delivered Peter out of prison. Peter was locked up in prison. Herod was trying to kill him the next day. The angel came and delivered him. Why? Because he had experienced divine embrace. Divine embrace activate the angels, God's servants, on your behalf. So put on him the best robe. The best robe. Not just anyone, but the best robe. In scriptures here, robe speaks of righteousness. Isaiah 61 verse 10 says, 61 10 of Isaiah says, I will greatly rejoice in the Lord. My soul shall be joyful in my God, for he hath clothed me with the garments of salvation. He hath covered me with the robe of righteousness. So, when we have divine embrace, Jesus puts upon us the divine robe of righteousness. Not your righteousness and man, which is like filthy rags, but the best robe, his own righteousness. Glory to God. His own righteousness become imputed to us because we have encountered divine embrace. Divine embrace brings you and I to the realm of God's righteousness, where sin is destroyed, the bondage of sin is broken, where the pull, the allurement to evil is wiped out, where the draw to uncleanness is deleted from your life. The realm where righteousness becomes your nature. The realm where you don't struggle to live holy because you have had divine embrace. In divine embrace, that robe of righteousness flows through you that day and night your life emits the purity and the righteousness of the God of heaven because you have had divine embrace. For anyone who is struggling with one sinful habit or the other, you have only one prescription, divine embrace. Just get divine embrace and you'll be clothed with the robe of righteousness. And the things that make others to trip and fall into sin, they will mean nothing to you whatsoever. You will not struggle to live holy. No, you will live holy by nature. Because you have had divine embrace, that robe of righteousness is on you, and you flow in God's righteousness. And everyone here in this meeting today, everyone hearing the sound of my voice, wherever you're hearing the sound of my voice, today is your moment for divine embrace. I prophesy that every work of sin in your life comes to an end today. Every bondage of iniquity, every spirit of uncleanness of any category that have been binding you, that hold breaks here today by divine embrace. By divine embrace. Somebody shout hallelujah. Any sinful habit you have been unable to break away from, today you break free from it by the power of God. By divine embrace. Glory to God. Put on him, he said, the robe of righteousness. The best robe is for those who have divine embrace. So when you have divine embrace, God clothes you with that righteousness. You find that your life is a life free from sin, a life free from the things of the world, a life lived in the realms of God's holiness, a life lived in the realms of God's glory. You just keep on enjoying God because you have had divine embrace. And you have been put, he has put on you the best robe of righteousness. Now, nobody can live holy by their power. Don't try it. It's a wasted effort. Don't even try. You can't do it. You can only live holy when you experience divine embrace. When he puts that robe on you, wow, your life becomes easygoing in the realms of God's holiness. This is the blessing of divine embrace, the robe of righteousness. 2 Corinthians 5:21. Paul says by the Holy Ghost, Amplified Bible, 2 Corinthians 5:31. For our sake, he made Christ virtually to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in and through him we might become endued with, viewed as being in, and examples of the righteousness of God. Glory to God. Which we ought to be approved and accepted and in right relationship with him by his goodness. This is the result of divine embrace. This is the key to living a life pleasing to God. A life that will make you happy yourself. A life of being in right tune with God is to shoot for divine embrace. Run to him for divine embrace. Divine embrace frees us from a life of sin. Number three, put on this, my son, the ring in his hand. So there's the ring that we receive in our spiritual hand through divine embrace. The father said, put the ring on my son's hand. What's the meaning of that? Ring simplifies covenant relationship. That's why in marriage they use wedding rings. It simplifies covenant relationships, plus it typifies honor, authority, and power. That's why when King Pharaoh was to make Joseph prime minister of Egypt, he pulled his ring from his hand and gave it to Joseph. Genesis 41:42. And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it upon Joseph's hand. He did that to show that Joseph, by that ring, now had authority and power to rule over the whole of Egypt. So ring in scripture here has two meanings. First of all, relationship. And two, authority and power. So divine embrace. You have come to God and divine embrace. God has put into your hands a special ring that gives you a special connection to God. You have the code to God's secret bedroom. You have the code. Oh, you have the code. You have this secret relationship with God that nobody can even understand. Because you have that divine embrace, you and God have become so close, so intimate. The ring means God has brought you to a place of intimacy with him that is private between you and him alone. It means deepened relationship with God. And then it means power and authority. That ring gives us dominion over devils. Power over the powers of darkness is because of divine embrace. He gave us the ring. Glory to God. Now we have power to cast out devils. We have power to rebuke evil spirits. If you don't know about this divine embrace, you will not be able to rebuke evil spirits. You will only try to appeal to evil spirits. But they are deaf and dumb. They are deaf and dumb. They don't hear appeal. Appeal to demons, you waste your time. That's why Christ didn't say, in my name, they shall appeal to devils. No, in my name, they shall cast out devils. It means devil, come out of him. Let him go. You don't say, that devil, please leave me alone. I don't want trouble. Oh, you say, really? Okay. You command him. That's a sign of the ring you receive in your hand by divine embrace. Power and authority. We can command devils and they obey us in the name of Jesus Christ. And in this meeting today, we are commanding every devil in your life to vacate. We are commanding every work of darkness in your life to be eliminated. Today, as I speak now, the demons are going. The demons are going already. They are going already. By the power of the authority Christ gave to us, we are commanding and demanding that every demonic oppression in your life come to an end today by the power of God. As you begin to pray shortly, you shall experience something strange wherever you are on the face of the earth. The power of God shall fall on you right here, wherever you are in the world, in divine embrace. I can't forget this. Some time ago, I was ministering like this, but on radio, in a radio program. And I was praying for the folks. And something strange happened from heaven. There's a couple in Liberia. You might be listening now. I don't know. A couple in Liberia. They were going through serious demonic attack. This was their story. Every morning they wake up, they will see live worms on their bed. Live worms on their bed. They will kill them, drive them away, go to sleep. Next morning, wake up, see live worms on the bed. They don't know where the worms are coming from. They clean the place out. Go to sleep. Next morning, wake up, see worms on the bed. Their life became worms infested. They went everywhere to look for a solution. Nothing happened. But one day during the program, as he began to pray, which we'll do shortly, as he began to pray, the woman said, the room suddenly became hot. The room became hot. Wow. The room became hot. She was wondering, why is the room getting hot? Getting hot. Before she knew, before their eyes, the bed caught fire physically, with no human being putting any fire to it. The fire that came down in the days of Elijah came down physically in that room. I began to burn on the bed. She said, wow. See, they pulled the mattress, pulled the bed, then they put out the fire. As they did that, they suddenly saw a black demonic pot under the bed. A satanic pot, clay pot, was under the bed. That's what the demons were. But when the power of God was released, they broke the pot, destroyed those things. That was the end of worms on their beds in the morning. That was the end. The same thing will be somebody's experience here today. I don't care what type of worms have been troubling you, what type of demons have been oppressing you, wherever they are coming from, wherever they operate, today, by the power of divine embrace, they are living your life for good. In the name of Jesus. If you expect that, let your amen show it. Say amen. Amen. Come on, glory to God. Hallelujah to Jesus. That's it. This is the benefit of divine embrace. He put the ring in our hands, and we have connection with God, and we have access to his power and authority. One of the dimensions of this closeness to God is the ability to pray in tongues. When you come, have divine embrace, and you are ready for everything God has for you, you will experience this intimate walk with God that is enhanced through speaking in other tongues. It does not matter who says that tongues are over. It doesn't matter who says that. Let them have 100 PhDs. They don't know nothing. Don't know nothing. Because Jesus, the same yesterday, today, and forever. Some will say, you know what? It's just for few people. It's for some in the church, not for all Christians. How? In Acts 2, when the Holy Ghost fell, he said they were all filled, not some, not most, all. Verse 4 says, and they all began to speak with tongues. All were filled. Acts 10, in the house of Cornelius, Holy Ghost fell, and they were all filled. Since when did God stop the all and began the selective one? No, it's the all for those who believe. And this is one of the dimensions of divine embrace. You have this fellowship with God, that you are speaking to God. Only God knows what you are saying. You are communing with God. The devil can't understand what you are saying. You black out demons. You are speaking this love language with your Father. It's intimate with your Father. It's a part of divine embrace. Divine embrace. Divine embrace gives us special relationship with God and authority over God's creation. Number 4, he says, servants, come, put shoes on his feet. Shoes on his feet. Divine embrace empowers our feet with divine shoes to take us to proclaim the gospel of Jesus Christ everywhere we go. That's it. Ephesians 6, verse 15. And your feet shod preparation of the gospel of peace. When you experience divine embrace, you become empowered to tell others about Jesus. If you are afraid or shy to talk about Jesus Christ to others, go and check your divine embrace level. Go and check your divine embrace level. If you have divine embrace, no shoes on your feet, anywhere you go, you are proud of your Jesus. You're like Paul says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. It's the power of God. You are proud of your Jesus. If you are shy or ashamed to be called a Christian, please go and get some divine embrace. Get some divine embrace. Get some shoes on your feet. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah to Jesus. Divine embrace equips us to win souls for Christ. And so let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Between now and next month program, how about you go and win some souls for Jesus? How about you tell others about Christ? Invite them to Jesus. Invite them to the monthly special miracle service. Invite them to church. Invite them to follow Jesus. That's one of the expressions of the benefits of divine embrace. The shoes are on your feet from heaven. Glory be to God. And finally, he said, go and kill the fatted calf. Let us start a party for the sake of my son. Let there be celebration on his behalf. When you have divine embrace, are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? Heaven throws party on your behalf. Oh, glory to God. There's celebration among the angels because of you. On your account, the angels begin to just dance and celebrate and give thanks to Jehovah because of you. You have embraced the Lord. The angels are happy for you. They are rejoicing for you. There's rejoicing in heaven on your behalf because of divine embrace. Somebody shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. For everyone who experienced divine embrace, there's party in heaven on your behalf. Not just for sinners who just come and get saved. Every single time you draw closer to God, and God comes to you, angels celebrate. Let me say it again. Not just when you come to Christ for the first time in your life as a sinner. No. Then they celebrate. But after that, whenever you draw close to God, and God draws close to you and embraces you, the angels celebrate you. So your divine embrace provokes angelic celebration on your behalf. So think about this. If the angels are celebrating because of you, why don't you join them and celebrate as well? Are you still here? So now, let's say you are doing your birthday. Everybody is just rejoicing. Oh, it's his birthday. They are rejoicing, it's his birthday. And you, who's in the birthday, you are just... Is that normal? No. If everybody is rejoicing on your birthday, you should also rejoice on your birthday. Is that correct? If the angels are celebrating you, then celebrate yourself. Say, glory to God, I'm saved. Glory to God, I'm a child of God. Glory to God, I'm a child of God. Oh, hallelujah, I'm saved. Praise God. Oh, glory to God. Celebrate yourself in God. This is a result of divine embrace. So divine embrace, as we embrace God's power, we provoke angelic activation. We put on the robe of righteousness. The ring comes on our hand from the Lord. We are on our shoes, the gospel of peace, and heaven celebrates us. So we must also celebrate ourselves because we have experienced divine embrace. As we're going to prayer right now, everyone get ready. Right here in this house, wherever you are watching from, wherever you are listening at, get ready now. I'm going to prayer right now. The power of God shall begin to move. Some of you may experience fire come physically where you are. Some of you may see angels suddenly. Now, Joshua was born blind in Liberia. Born blind. He was listening to our radio program in Liberia. As he began to pray, born blind, not 2-year-old boy. He was, he's a father of two children, born blind. As the prayer was going on, suddenly, even he was born blind, he saw in his mind a man robed in white appeared and said, "See!" He's open. Began to see for the first time in his life. So as we are praying now, there's no telling what can happen. The angels have been deployed. The angels have been activated. The angels have been released. So right now in this house and wherever you are on the face of the earth, please close your eyes and bow your heads now. How great thou art. Bow your heads, please, and close your eyes. Jesus, we thank you right now. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Remember what we learned. To provoke divine embrace is to turn your undivided attention to Jesus and draw close to him. Then he runs to you and you experience divine embrace, resulting in these five fantastic blessings. Jesus, the miracles are happening already. The miracles are happening already. Lord, we give you thanks. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, unto thee, miracle working God, how great thou art. Right here in this place, and anywhere you are hearing us from right now, pray this prayer with me. Let it come from the depth of your heart. Say, oh God. Say, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I repent of my sin. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Lord Jesus, I yield myself to you. I surrender my life to you. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Make me your child forever. Thank you, wonderful one. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, unto thee, awesome Father, how great thou art. Thank you, Jesus. How great thou art. Thank you, Lord. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, unto thee, amazing Father. Now, if you want to experience divine embrace, please hear me closely. Just close your eyes and be in the Spirit. Close your eyes and be in the Spirit wherever you are. Right now, with your eyes closed, turn your attention to Jesus. Right now. Turn your focus to Jesus Christ, my God. See him. Don't see the man of God anymore. Just see Jesus. Close your eyes and just focus your attention on Jesus. Focus your whole attention on Jesus. That's it. Yes. Focus all your attention on Jesus right now. Right now. Right now. And now in the name of Jesus, go to him in the Spirit. Go to Jesus in the Spirit. Tell him, Lord, I come to you. Jesus, I draw nigh to you. Tell him that. Your eyes closed. Tell him, Jesus, I draw near to you. Lord, I draw near to you, Jesus. 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 Now, when I count 1, 2, 3, something will happen. Both here in this house and wherever you are connected to this meeting from. But just follow me. Close your eyes and you'll see Jesus. Close your eyes and see Jesus. Tell him, Lord, I come to you. Lord, I come to you. Tell him that, Lord Jesus, I draw near to you. Lord Jesus, I draw near to you. I draw near to you for a divine embrace. Lord, I draw near to you for a divine embrace now. Yes, thank you, Heavenly Father. Now, when I count 1, 2, 3, divine embrace will happen. Many of you will sense something from heaven now. As the Lord will embrace you by himself, you will sense both here in this house and wherever you are hearing or watching us from. Get ready for another dose of divine embrace right now. Thank you, wonderful Jesus, for granting your sons and daughters divine embrace right now. All over, all over. In the mighty name of Jesus, 1, 2, 3. Receive divine embrace from heaven now. Lagodes aframandaka galastongonomo senvenegunga. Lekenemenzolo bobo sanavalavamba. Ekelebrekado bodo soligongo. Lekle makablagadasia falamaso kanga. Ekapenopoloso nefe sefilefe. Elekre mevelakato sevini agadibembembe. Ekonoma zantaka, 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 zadagola. Fekela shagilage. Enokra menshi fi avabe sopolobombo. Enuka sketele feliska utaklomba. Velek menshe felivilaiva. By this divine embrace, I command sickness to disappear now. Every demon of affliction, I command you, come out in the name of Jesus Christ. Every spirit of infirmity, every devil of bondage, I adjure thee by God in Jesus' name. Come out of the people now. In the name of Jesus, the Son of God, I speak healing to the sick right now. I declare deliverance for those that are bound. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet, be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed in the name of Jesus. And be loosed from that bondage. Be loosed in the name of Jesus. Every afflicting devil, come out of the people. Sataba vekonga. Come out in the name of Jesus. Evele saprato seligash. The afflicting devil, lose your hold now. Go in the name of Jesus. Yes, yes, yes. There's angelic operations now. In the name of Jesus, be healed, be delivered, be set free, be loose from your bondage now. In the name of Jesus, the Son of God. Lamaka venkonogongo. From the top of your head to the soles of your feet, be healed in the name of Jesus. Afflicting devils, come out. Go in the name of Jesus. Emeketo segola. Segola mikenge. Every yoke of witchcraft, break now in the name of Jesus. Thife mefe soro manva denge mondo sondo stoiga. Every witchcraft hold, break now in the name of Jesus. Vilevos Zagadaga. In the name of Jesus, rise up and walk. In Jesus' name, rise up and walk now. in the name of Jesus. Rise up and walk in the name of Jesus. Zataso lifelebede. Entering training. Ringing ear. Stop ringing now. Stop ringing now. Deaf ear, open in the name of Jesus. Vesca, Vesotele, Levestonga. Stomach ulcer, dry up now and vanish in the name of Jesus. Pain in the knees and the ankles, disappear now. Go in the name of Jesus, the Son of God. La patose fekela salugush. Witchcraft spirits, crawling devils, cash fire burnt to ashes now. In the name of Jesus. Mente sota fegida. Flying devils, cash fire burnt to ashes now. In the name of Jesus. Lobo lefiyaka. Closed doors of blessings open now. Somebody's doors just swung open. Doors of blessings just swung open now for somebody. Doors of blessings just swung open for somebody now. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Elalobo sakaba lefelages. My God, we give you praise. How great thou art. Thank you, Lord, for divine embrace. Lord, embrace everyone whose heart is crying out to you right now. Embrace everyone afresh. Let there be release of angelic activation. Let the robe of righteousness be dropped upon everyone. In the name of Jesus Christ, let that ring come on everyone's hand. Let their shoes put on the gospel of feet. Of the gospel, show of the gospel in Jesus' name. Let there be celebration on their behalf in heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ, now. My God, I give it. It's happening right now. Meskolo lefilos. In the name of Jesus, be loose, be set free by the power of God. Asatagabasha. In Jesus' name. Everyone here in this room who wants me to lay hands on you, step forward now. Now is the hour. I mean, step forward now. Those of you who are watching right there where you are, the power of God is coming on you right there where you are. In the name of Jesus. Yes, you have some testimonies there.
Yes, we have some testimonies coming in already.
My God, my God,
Martha
my God.
Martha Strada just tested the radio station.
Yes.
As she tuned in the radio, her radio, she felt a powerful release, a relief from a horrible headache she had been going through for days.
My God,
the
my God.
The pain has gone.
Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
And we have another testimony. Mm-hmm. Somebody said, Austin Kamara.
Yes.
He said, incoming test on the station number.
Yes.
Mr. and Mrs. Joseph Holmes.
Yes.
Have tested. Day to instantly receive the Holy Spirit baptism.
Wow, right now. My God.
He said, Apostle, they once laughed and mocked those who spoke in unknown tongues.
Yes, but right now.
But as the woman of God began to lead prayers,
yes,
their Sierra Leonean English turned to unknown tongues.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Life. Glory Hallelujah. To God. That's the part. Any more there?
Yes. From Testimony FM Ghana.
Now, hold on. These are miracles happening right now in the course of the service. Go ahead, please.
It says, a family whose only son left them for 7 years to travel to Algeria.
Mm-hmm.
No call, no text from them.
For seven years,
they thought he was dead.
Hmm.
Only now, while listening to Divine Embrace, he came home.
Glory to God. After 7 years, he appeared home. Jesus, we give you thanks.
His name, Kwame Ajayi.
Glory to God.
They thought it was a dream.
My God.
But like Daddy Thomas, they said they will only believe by touching his face.
That it was real.
And he did, they touch him.
Glory to God. Awesome, awesome, awesome. These are miracles happening right now in the course of this program.
Another testimony just came in. From Austin Camara,
Jesus.
He said her daughter has begun suffering from hearing in her right ear for years. As you began to pray, the power of God opened her daughter's right ear right now.
My God. And the ear can hear now. My God. The ear that wasn't hearing now is hearing. By the power of God. Father, we give you praise. Glory to God. No. Right there where you are, keep on receiving the miracles. Let the music keep on playing. I will lay hands on my people here right now. And the power of God will flow upon you from your head to your feet. The power of God is coming on you right now. Jesus, we thank you. Blessed be your name forevermore. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Now, in the name of Jesus, God's Holy Son, receive from heaven now. Makabo Shaparaga. That's it. Receive now in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Kabasha Parapa. Let him go from this very moment. Touch him no more in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. You foul spirit of darkness, in the name of Jesus, loose him. Come out of him. I say, come out of him and enter no more into him. In the name of Jesus, the Son of God. Let him go now. From this very moment. Enter no more. In the name of Jesus. Come out of him. Let him go. Makaso nefines. Elaklama vekoma zeniglo zeniga debidesh. Somebody help. Jesus. How great thou art. Come closer. Jesus, I thank you. Receive from heaven today. Oh God, bless this mother. Bless this mother. Holy Spirit, bless her. Lord, bless her for me and for her children. Intervene for her right now, Holy Spirit. Intervene for her right now, Father. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, every work of hell, I command you, loose her, let her go. In the name of Jesus, loose her now. And afflict her no more. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus of Nazareth, in the name of Jesus, Vekaba Shapalapa, Nekrima Faruma Sakata. Please come. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, Lord unto thee. Holy Spirit, thank you for touching your daughter now. Touch her by your power in Jesus' name. Meet her at the point of her need now. Loose! In the name of Jesus, Spirit of God, come on her now with power. That's the power of God. That's the power of God. Take it in. Take it in the name of Jesus. Take it in, Lord. Lift her in the spirit realm, Father. Lift her by your power. Transform her today. Transform her today to a new place in the Holy Ghost. Vado sive reve yeke laga. Yes, the glory is on you, sister. The glory is on you. Just receive the glory of the Father. The glory is on you. Just receive from heaven today. Lord Jesus, thank you for breathing upon your daughter that from today she won't be the same anymore. Thank you, Lord, for touching your daughter, blessing her, blessing her. Everything from your past that has been running after you, I cut them off now with the sword of the Spirit. Cut them off from your past. I cut them off from your past now. Receive blessing from heaven today. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you for your power. It's upon your daughter. Thank you, Jesus. Then sings my soul, My Savior God, Lord unto thee.
Touch and bless him, O God. Bless him by your power.
In the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Oh God, we give you praise. Blessed be your name, Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Blessed be God. Blessed be God. Then sings, my soul, my Savior God, unto thee.
God is touching you, my sister. The Lord's hands are upon you right now. In the name of Jesus, receive from heaven by the Holy Ghost right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The presence of God is all over you now. Take it. Flows from your head to your feet. That's the presence of Jesus. Heaven is on you now. Heaven is all over you now. Heaven is all over you now. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, blessed be your name, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Heaven is on you now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, yes. It's flowing from your head to your feet. Raising you to a new realm in God right now. To the glory of God the Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. It's released. It's released. It's released. It's released from heaven. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Blessed be the name of God, my Father. Then sings my soul. Everyone just begin to thank the Lord right now. Right here in this place, wherever you are listening out or you are watching, just begin to thank God right now. Thank God for the mighty miracles that we have already recorded. Thank God. Lift your hands and begin to glorify the name of Jesus. Begin to magnify the name of the Lord for the miracles, for his blessings upon us today. Father, we thank you. Blessed be the mighty name of Jesus. Glory to our Father forever. Hallelujah. Glory to God in the highest. Lord Jesus, we celebrate you today. Thank you, Lord, for this divine embrace and for the miracles going with us today. Thank you, Father. Blessed be the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. Now, if you want further prayers, when we close, just wait behind. If you want further prayers, when we close, wait behind. I'll be glad to minister to you and pray with you if you need more prayers. By the grace of Jesus, we are back here next month for the next episode of our monthly miracle service. I want to thank you for being a part of this program today. I want to challenge you to spread the news. Have you been blessed being here today? Are you blessed being here today? Answer me, are you blessed or no? You are blessed, then spread the news. Tell your neighbors, tell those around you to come and partake of this next month. You had miracles happening right in the middle of the service. There's no telling what God has done today. It's amazing. So spread the news. Tell your folks about this program. You'll get the flyer of the next one as soon as possible. And also, sow your financial seed to support this ministry. Sow your financial seed to support the ministry. Please, you may be seated. You may be seated. There are different ways you can sow your seed. You can do cash donation here. You can do Zelle. You can do Cash App. You can go to our website, israeljima.org. While you are there, you can give. You can sow your seed. As you sow your seed, you can decide whether you want it to be a monthly partner to the ministry. You see, the options will be there to select monthly or one-time gift. Anyone you choose, as God leads you, is fine. But when you sow your seed into this good ground, I assure you, you got the harvest from heaven. Say amen to that. I don't know if you know that this ministry is good ground. You know that? I know it is. See the lives who have been saved by the power of God all over the place? It's a sign of a good soil to sow your money into. So when you sow your seed into this good ground, expect the harvest. So you go to israeljima.org. Right there on the homepage, if you scroll down, you will see the option to give. When you click that option, if you put a page that will ask you, do you want to give one time or you want to give recurrently? Choose the one that God lays on your heart and sow your seed. And God will bless you as you do that.
Man of God, we have another testimony here.
Please let us hear. If you can lower the music a little bit.
It says, Jerome wrote several applications, having graduated 3 years ago,
mm-hmm.
has another master, no job.
I wonder if master has degree, no job.
Yeah, no job. He is listening to Testimony FM. A call came that tomorrow, Tuesday, he should come and interview.
Wow. Praise
Hallelujah.
God. Praise God. That's a mighty open door for him. While listening, God opened door for him.
Amen. And said, today I renew and dedicated my life to God.
Amen.
I had backslidden a few months ago.
Mm-hmm.
Now today, today's word from the man of God touched me. I am weeping as I send this text to this station.
Oh, Jesus,
number.
Jesus.
Thanks, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. It's so just got saved. God's drawn to Jesus.
Amen.
Clap your hands for Jesus.
Glory.
Blessed be God. Hallelujah. I want to let you know that today God has reached over 500,000 people through this broadcast, through this meeting, via radio only. In Pakistan, it's 20 million have just been reached by Jesus through this program. And you don't know what God has done today. It's huge. It's mighty. So as I close the service, I want to thank you all for being in the house with me today. Go spread the news and sow your seed. If you want to get more prayer, wait behind. I'll be happy to pray with you. This is the advantage you have when you are here in person. Those of you who are watching online, once we close, that's it. But if you are here, you have the privilege of more prayers, one-on-one prayer for deliverance every last Monday like this. Lord, we give you the praise and the glory for your mercy and for your grace. We give you thanks for divine embrace. We go rejoicing. We go blessed by your power. So as you go, I decree upon you God's divine blessings. That as you go in the name of Jesus, whatever used to be troubling you, when you get back, the trouble shall be resolved. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Receive your blessing today and love the Lord and serve him. In Jesus' holy name. Don't forget, Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forever. And in him, we win.